corner change. But this third session, listen, it was the best of times for Jack Beckman. It was the worst of time for both of these drivers. Jim Campbell, the car on the left side of your screen right now, is going to go through a big-time explosion. He's a rookie making his first ever national event debut. That's a serious fire. But the bigger concern is in the other lane. Short racetrack here. Gary Densham's got no parachutes. Look and listen to what he just endured. A very scary incident. We all held our collective breaths until Gary Densham, with the help of NHRA Safety Safari, was able to climb out of that tangled mess. Now, at the end of each and every racetrack, Tony, the safety precautions are in place. A long gravel slowdown lane, a couple of catch fences, some water barrels behind that. They did their job. Gary's car did its job. His safety equipment did everything to get him out of this.
Everything held up, but this Pomona racetrack is notorious for chewing cars up and spitting them out. The reason for that is it's a very short shutdown area. The primary braking system of these cars are parachutes. There were no parachutes on that run. There almost seemed to be some brake failure, but you could almost hear the car skipping. Gary was violently trying to pull the brake.
Yep.
On a 307 mile an hour run, the driver almost has to time those parachutes so they come right out at the finish line. And if nothing happens, at this point, Gary knows he's just going to tense up. He knows what's in front of him.
Why is Auto Club Raceway a tad short? Remember, this is a track that opened in 1950. Who knew that 40, 45 years later, and routinely beyond that up to 2016, cars would eclipse 300 miles an hour. But when 69-year-old independent funny car racer Gary Densham climbed out, John Kernan was there with him. A lot on his mind.
Well, thankfully, Gary Densham has gotten out of his car with assistance from the Safety Safari. And Gary, what a scary ride. Take us through that.
Well, you know, I don't know how come the parachutes didn't open. I mean, the car felt like it ran pretty good. I don't even know what it ran, but seemed like it was pretty good. And then the parachutes didn't open and ended up down here. And I guess that had a great career. It's been wonderful. And it's good to have all these guys in Safety Safari. Takes all the fear out of running these cars because they're going to do a great job no matter what. And this might be the end of it for us, but you know, unfortunately, that's the way it goes, but it had to happen. It's great to be here at Pomona and have it happen.
You ran a 405, just to let you know. The chutes didn't come out, and when you're carrying that kind of speed, I guess the brakes don't help either.
Not enough, just not enough. I mean, it's, you know, nobody's fault. It's just what happens, you know? It's a shame it had to happen. When you only got one car and no way to get another one, but that's the way it goes.
But you know what, Gary, the most important thing? You're okay, thank goodness.
Yeah, we'll go out racing my kid's car and we'll have a great time.
Of course, left in the wreckage behind him, that tangled mess. Quick hug from his wife, Joanne, on the scene. John Force right away saying, hey, if I can do anything, I will do what I can. Gary Densham is qualified for this field, so that's what happens out here, though. Racers come to the help of other racers, for sure.